It's really difficult. You know, when you, I can take any athlete and teach them how to box because they know how to, they know how to move their body in the proper manner. But you can put that, take that same athlete, put a stick in their hand, and they're gonna be fumbling around. They don't kind of control it. So I mean, we tell everybody, it's, you know, everybody gets all confused. I'm like, I don't know if I can do this, and it's like, and I tell them, you know, you're in control of that eighth of an inch bubble around your body, but now we've got to do something that's outside of that bubble. You have to be able to wield and control this weapon. So the Filipino martial arts will start you with a longer weapon generally because it's more difficult to deal with. And we start with some longer hand ranges. The first drill that we normally do is called six count serrata. And it's because in the drill, I do 3 counts and he does 3 counts. Okay, and it's an attack and defense drill. So I'll attack him with an angle one. It's really a defense here. And I'll do a defense. And we'll just go back and forth. And this, where he's attacking me, and I'm attacking and defending him. And then from inside of this drill, I have defenses and disarms that I can do within there. Just because of your close proximity to us, I will stick to only a few of them. So one of the disarms that we would do is from this position called an inside sweep. I'll soften him up a little bit with a strike, and I'll roll this over and come to here. I think I can see I can take his stick from him. Okay, and that we call a vine disarm. That's one where I can maintain control of the stick and not send it inadvertently into you guys. So we go back into this drill, and I can do that same disarm from this position. Okay. And then I can also do that same disarm, or a version of it, from right here. And I can take the stick from. And the stick is great because it's a surrogate for just about any blunt instrument that you can imagine in any way, shape, or form. A police baton, mag light, flashlight, a wrench, you know, anything that you could possibly imagine that might either A, come swinging at you, or that you could use to swing at them. So down the road, as you get more and more control over the tip of your weapon, then you can start not hitting the stick, and I can hit his forearm. And so he'll hit my forearm. Okay? And that's because we both have control over it, and we can do that. Because ideally, I don't want to deal with this weapon again. I just want to smash his hand and not have to deal with that again. Okay. And so as we get more and more into it, I can also now train everything on the head. So instead of doing the disarm here, I'll do and hit his head, and then he'll hit my head. And I hit his head, he hits my head, I hit his head, right? And so we can go through all of this, and then I can even put my, he puts his angle forward, I can put my strike to the head, and then finish my disarm. And then I have all the So that's called six counts of product. And so you have, from the six count, once you get this down, this is where it changes into 10 count. This is called a drop stick with a check. I'm checking his arm and stopping his weapon from hitting me and then smashing his hand. From this position, it just changes if we go into 10 count, where he's doing 5 counts, I'm doing 5 counts. I'm gonna pass his hand through and I'm gonna try to thrust him. And then we go into 10 counts. With this that I could before, I can go right back into six count if I want. I can do all the same disarm progressions and striking the hand and head progressions with this weapon. And this is all at the medium range. And then when you progress into a little bit closer range, what'll happen is when I do this defense here, instead of coming over here, I'm gonna come in and try to hit it with the butt of my stick. This is called Julio Sobrada. It's a little bit closer range, so I'm going to hit here, and then I'll try to come up and hit him. And then we'll flow back into this. So you see we're entering into a different range here, gradually working closer when you get there. what hoopa means, hoopa and lupa, it means to tie and untie. So you can see we're in really close proximity to each other right now. And at any point, one of us can decide to push back out into this longer range, okay? And so we'll eventually move into to different forms of this. Now, like I said, this weapon can be a surrogate for just about anything, okay? Anything going right down to knives. And so I spent 7 years, don't mob me, but I spent 7 years in the Army. So, times, my wife will tell you, that I miss it every day, you know, and really, you know, I'm thankful. And I tell my students, the ones that haven't, the ones that haven't trained or haven't been in the military, I tell my students, you know, you can go out and do whatever you want and act like a fool, all because of what you guys do for us. You know, you guys are going out and doing these things that not everybody wants to do. And people don't get that. And so I just want to let you know that there are a bunch of us out there that can.